Hey everyone, and welcome to the 8th ImagineFun Newswire. It's been a while since our last announcements, and I'm excited to share some of the stuff we've been creating on the server with you. I'll be announcing our next ride opening very soon, but first, I'll be passing it over to Slinks to round up 2021.
Now, let's take a look back at some of the monumental milestones we hit in 2021. In 2021 alone, we welcomed 175,458 brand new guests to the server. Over the past year, we've also added some 16 new rides to our ever-growing list of nearly 40 attractions. We started taking guests on Grand Circle tours of the Magic Kingdom on the Disneyland Railroad in February. Throughout April and May, much of Fantasyland saw new upgrades, renovations, and reopenings featuring Alice in Wonderland, Mr. Toad's Wild Ride, Peter Pan's Flight, and Snow White's Enchanted Wish, along with Bugs Land opening to the public in California Adventure. Jump ahead to early July, and we unveiled 6 attractions with the brand new Pixar Pier debut. Following its opening, you could take a high-speed ride on the Incredicoaster, learn how to fly with Goofy Sky School, go under the sea on Ariel's Undersea Adventure, and much more. In September, we began sending tours out into the depths of the jungle on the Jungle Cruise. And most recently, we unveiled Avengers Campus in late October, fit with Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, taking the former place of the Tower of Terror. We also saw over 1,900 new 3D models added to the server, nearly 10 million chat messages, and almost 20 million individual commands were sent. We also donated $10,000 to charitable causes during our Coins for Change fundraiser, which in-game raised just shy of 73 million Kingdom Coins, and you all totaled over 3 million rides on our various attractions last year alone. Of those rides, here are our top 5 most ridden attractions of 2021. Coming in at number 5 is Finding Nemo Submarine Voyage, with 136,862 rides. Sailing over to the Spanish Main is Pirates of the Caribbean in 4th, with 161,870 individual rides. Number 3 is the Disneyland Railroad, taking guests on 195,250 Grand Circle tours. Jumping over to Pixar Pier, we have Jumpin' Jellyfish in 2nd, with 211,818 rides. Last is Radiator Springs Racers, totaling 219,664 rides, taking the title for our most ridden ride in 2021. Thanks again for spending time with us this past year, and we can't wait to see what the future has in store.
Thank you, Slinks, for that amazing roundup. Speaking of which, I'll be rounding up our latest incredible content releases in just a moment. Some of these will have released in the last month or so, whereas others will be releasing very soon. This doesn't even include the incredible February events, which will include a winter ball and tons of meet and greets. Join our Discord to see when we announce more details, and you can also get pinged when meet and greets occur. Now, without further ado, here's some recent updates on the server. We've centralized our currency across the server. Rather than having 3 separate currencies, everything will be priced according to Kingdom Coins from now on. Kingdom Coins are equal in value to pennies. Therefore, one castle is equal to 64 Kingdom Coins, and so on. While this update happened a little while ago, changes are still happening in stages to adjust pricing and stores to better match the update. We hope this all makes the currency a little bit less confusing for both newcomers and for returning guests. Need an extra locker or two? Larry's got you covered. Visit the Downtown Disney lockers at Slash Warp Lockers to buy these larger storage units, which can not only hold normal items, but also hold other storage items when they get too full. Users with ranks already get access to lockers as a perk, but if you need an extra, Larry can hook you up. Vote parties are here! Voting on the server is when you, our guests, type /vote and visit a website to vote for our server. Your vote helps us come up on server lists more frequently, and therefore allows more people to see us and join the server. As a reward for voting now, not only do you get a vote key for the vote crate, but your vote also counts towards the vote party. Every 200 votes, all online players who have voted in the past 24 hours will get a box with a random item inside. These items will shift and change over time, and there will even be items exclusive to these vote party boxes. Now, here's a look at some projects that we've discussed in the past, but haven't quite come to fruition on the server yet. The 1.17 update is still in development. We're actually completely done with the code portion of the move, and since then we've been slowly upgrading the 1.17 quality of play. Soon you'll be able to see different chat icons in this version for things like tours, fireworks, and more. These small touches are super fun, and will eventually be important once the full update arrives, though we don't have a set date for that in mind. The retro server is now partially opened. You can use /server retro1 to visit Bugsland and the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror if you feel like riding those attractions. Paradise Pier and the Sunshine Plaza aren't open yet, however, since they both require massive overhauls to the areas around them, and that takes a lot of time. Those areas will open as major expansions at a later date, but aren't a huge priority compared to attractions that are still in the parks today. It's a small world. And that does it for status updates. To be clear, when we delay things, they aren't permanently shelved or tossed by any means. We only have so much time in a day, and we typically choose to prioritize things we can actually get done in a timely manner, and have the technological means to create in an innovative and well-thought-out way. The quality of our rides is above all else, so when we have the means to finish a project, we do so to the best of our ability. Speaking of updates, here's some new content we'll be adding very soon. As always, we're constantly finding ways to improve previous builds and areas around the server. The resort is constantly evolving, and I enjoy seeing people notice the small changes here and there as we make them. The main changes you'll begin to notice starting tomorrow are as follows. An ongoing refurbishment of Grizzly Peak, which will include redoing most of the greenery all around the land. A small new area in the mall, which I've heard is long abandoned. A few changes in the Fantasy Fair area. A small facelift in the area around the Matterhorn. And many more small touch-ups. We've also updated the Theater Club showcase in Soundstage 17 with the latest shows and a new music loop, so feel free to check that out at /warp soundstage17. Our first additional Jungle Cruise skippers will be making their way to the attraction very soon. I'm very happy to announce two brand new skippers today. The first is SaberSpark, of the YouTube channel of the same name, who will be giving tours on the attraction starting tomorrow. I highly recommend checking out his channel, and I hope you enjoy seeing him on the ride. Secondly, I'm happy to announce award-winning actress Carmina Garay from the hit Disney Plus series Diary of a Future President will be giving tours on the attraction beginning on Friday, February 4th. If you have Disney Plus, definitely check out the show. It's one of my personal favorite original series on the platform. Sometime in the coming weeks, we'll also be adding Stacey Sheebs and Katie Katz as skippers of their own boats. These two characters are still in their voice acting and editing phases, however, so it'll be a little while before they're ready. We can't wait to showcase more skippers on the attraction as we're able to going forward. Now I'm going to pass you over to Soggy to talk about quests and the new quest lines coming soon.
Quests are now available on the server. Find an NPC with a gold exclamation point above their head and enjoy being a part of a fun and unique storyline. Currently, we have 7 stories across the various lands of Disneyland Park, totaling in over 200 missions and hours of fun. After you complete each land's quest, you receive an exclusive item. This is just the beginning of quests, and we will continue to bring you more and unique ways to interact with your favorite characters in the coming months. We've got more fun and exciting quests headed to the server soon. In February, we're launching limited edition quests based off of Lunar New Year and Valentine's Day. Lunar New Year quests will be available from February 1st until February 15th, and Valentine's Day quests will be available from February 11th until February 28th. Each of these quests will have exclusive, limited edition items as rewards, and you'll get to explore stories with some of your favorite characters from Mulan, the Owl House, and Encanto, among some others as well. We also have one other permanent quest line surrounding a ride release that's coming up this month, but you're gonna have to wait just a bit longer before you hear some more details about that. Happy questing, everyone!
Good news for all you Gold Castle Mall fans. After closing down shop for some time, Sands has decided to begin leasing its store to a brand new company. In a statement from the skeleton himself, they're a respectable and reliable new business. I can only imagine what the people who run it must be like.
Mamma mia. Grazie, Mr. Sands, for this lovely lease. With this new property, we can finally start the ImagineFun Postal Service. The IFPS, if you will. In Indeed it is, il mio amico scheletro.
It's official, the IF Postal Service has moved in. They're going to be a core part of how you can access one of our website's newest features, the Marketplace. Using the online market couldn't be simpler. Head on over to ImagineFun.net and click Market at the top of your page. Logging in is super simple. After pushing login, you just need to authorise with Discord. It's important that you have a linked Discord to your game profile, but if you don't worry, you can join our Discord and someone will be more than happy to help. Once you've logged in, you can browse the whole market. The images may look a bit strange for now, but don't fear, you can view a 3D model in the individual listings page. If you're still not sure about how it looks, checking in-game will be your best bet. Once you've found an item you like, you can hit the buy now or specifically choose one of the items to place a buy order. After a short wait, you'll get your result. If you happen to be logging at the time, don't worry, the item has been reserved under your name. Head over to the IF Postal ATM to complete your transaction. If not, head on over to the delivery NPC. Once your transaction has been fully paid, either through the ATM or online, you'll be able to collect it at the delivery NPC, as I mentioned earlier. We spent the last month or so working on making this as good as we can, but don't fear, plans for searching and more are in place and will be coming soon. I can't wait for you all to start receiving your mail, and the postal service will be officially opened next weekend, the 29th of January. Oh my god, I was holding in that cough for so long.
Thank you, Tom, for showing us that cool new addition to the market. Now, I suppose I should go head out for that ride reveal. I don't even know what it is yet, but I'm excited to find out. Wait a second. This isn't a ride. This is an entire land. And I want to tell you now, welcome to Toontown. Come crowd around me and tune on today. It's a no frown upside down town where toons all live and play. Welcome to Toontown, where you can stay on a toon holiday. Don't you be a maroon, come commune with the toon. Huh, would you look at that? Back to the montage. Yeah, come on to Toontown. Oh, come on to Toontown. Yeah, we're welcoming you to Toontown today. You heard it here first, folks! Toontown's opening its gates next weekend on January 28th for all DVC members, and January 29th for the general public. At opening, there will be three rides in the land: Gadget's Go Coaster, Roger Rabbit's Cartoon Spin, and the long-abandoned Jolly Trolley. Lots of new technology was used to create a lot of what you see here, including the first use of Blender to control a dark ride at Roger Rabbit's. On this ride, you'll be able to control how the ride vehicle spins, just like a thrill park. Simply use A and D on your keyboard, or the equivalent if you've remapped them, to spin side to side as the ride goes on. There will also be tons of interactive elements you can find littered all around the land, like this firehouse doorbell, or these plates that make sounds on the ground near the instrument fountain. You really never know what to expect when you interact with something. I really hope to see you all next Friday and Saturday, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Now, I'm off to finish the final touches on the land. Thanks for playing, as always, and I'll see you real soon.